I like being called a renegade, by the way. Yeah. I kind of seem, well, I'm sort of typical kind of Generation X, really. I'm Steve Bowerman. I'm the principal software engineer for EDF's customers business. I've never been someone that enjoys the status quo. I think it's too easy to kind of get stuck in a rut just to not challenge yourself in the way we're doing things, because ultimately, if you're not doing it, others will.
I was recruited into EDF when they were assembling all of the software engineering teams, and I have a lot of experience in building teams, building high performance teams. EDF as a whole had a few software engineers, but they were scattered within multiple different teams, different parts of the organization. What we wanted to do was to bring that all together and have a common centralized engineering team, more of a concrete strategy on what we wanted to do and how we wanted to build it. For me personally, I saw a lot of opportunities, essentially a blank canvas to leave my print on, and that sold the job.
We try not to kind of pigeonhole people by calling them front-end developers and back-end developers. We tend to just use the broad term software engineer. Sometimes prefer to kind of use the term we're consultants that can code. So I really encourage our engineering community to kind of really get to the understanding of our business problems and kind of what our customers and consumers are demanding from us, and obviously go off and codify that into practical applications.
I didn't really expect EDF to be quite as forward as it is. At first I thought we might just be simply automating scripts with, say, Excel. But instead we've got this massive, say, cloud architecture where we basically intake data, we process it, we put it all on AWS, and then we create applications based on that.
Although EDF has been around for a long time, it's by no means a traditional company. EDF is very, very at the cutting edge, I think, particularly in technology and data science.
IT historically has been quite conservative, quite slow moving, and I think that's now starting to be a much more environment that's fun and exciting. Data and tech grad scheme that we've got on board has also helped to inject a little bit of vibrancy in that, and it's really exciting to see a much more diverse group of younger individuals as well joining the organisation.
When I was applying for graduate schemes, I applied for quite a lot of different graduate schemes. The thing that really made me choose EDF over any of the others was, firstly, just the atmosphere, how everybody was at the assessment centre I went to, how the staff interacted with each other and with myself. It just made it feel like the sort of environment I would want to work in.
What I really like about this team is that they're all really friendly. No question is a stupid question, and trust me, I've tried. They are really good at just taking you through things from the basics, and they're really enthusiastic about things. They want you to get everything out of like a project that you can.
We also have a great culture that really helps you to achieve work-life balance. We're not strict to the 9-to-5, you know, if you want to start work earlier, finish work earlier, we're very open to that. I always go out for a nice walk at lunchtime and make sure I get out.
For me, being able to kind of get out midday or to get out sort of first thing in the morning for a run or last thing, and actually sometimes I find that it's ideal just to kind of get away from the desk for an hour and, you know, process some thoughts, that's really helpful for me.
Another reason why I chose EDF is to focus on battling climate change. As an individual, it's felt something so intangible, something I can't possibly do anything about. EDF's motto is literally helping Britain achieve net zero, being able to work somewhere where I can do what I want and use my skills in a context that is able to help climate change really appeal to me.
It's kind of in the ethos of the company that you're encouraged to go out and like teach other people. So we've had opportunities to volunteer and teach refugees how to code and about data science, which has been a great opportunity.
For us, we want someone who is open-minded, like a free thinker, who's basically able to, you know, speak truth to power, which is a key phrase that we throw around a lot. What we wanted to build was just this place which is completely inclusive, very democratic, has those principles and key values.
Most people have to sort of leave a company to change their role and get a new injection of life. With a large company like EDF, you don't need to do that. You can move around. If you talk to most people about this, why they stay with the company for such a long time, it's constantly evolving as a progressive organisation, but it's also the people are great. The bit that sort of keeps people retained is just working with good people who just muck in and get it done. It's really good. Yeah.